Well, welcome to another match of the band series. For this match, I decided to cut the mirror entity. It wasn't really performing very well. Every time I drew it, I didn't really want to cast it. It seems a lot better in Legacy when it has interactions with Symbiote, and you also have Gaia's Cradle, so you just have this consistent source of like a pile of mana to just Alpha Strike people. It wasn't really happening with this version of the deck, so I cut it for the fourth Court of Calling. This hand's pretty sweet. We've got Combo Elves, we've got a Curio, we've got a Glimpse of Nature, we've got an opponent mulling to four, I guess. I guess that's a thing he can do. Basic Mountain Pass. And we're going to lead with Llanowar Elves. It's the one that we want him to burn. Between these, he passes with Cascade Bluffs. Cascade Bluffs implies Twin. There's no turn to kill in the modern version of this deck. We already have a white source in our hand, so I'm just going to get a normal forest. I'm just going to put this Curio into play. Hopefully. Hopefully he doesn't remand it. Yep. And then next turn, we can stick this Glimpse, we can just win. That's what that Glimpse of Nature is going to mean. Maybe not now. Now we would need to play all the elves in our hand. Deceiving. No, we might just lose here. Oh, and we played the Curio on turn two. Maybe we should have dumped our hand into the Curio, because then any elf we play... I don't know, man. Yeah, if he has Twin here, we just... he's on Moldaphor on the play. You need to have mana plus Twin, and he's only had two exact cards. I think we're fine. Yeah. So what I'm going to do here is just set up for the turn 4 win by playing both these Heritage Druids. It's a little awkward if he has specifically Electrolyze, but... What? What a troll. He just plays the fourth land, taps as though he's gonna perfect us. That's super troll. Alright, time to win the game. Assuming this resolves. I don't think they have hard counters for sorceries, though. So I believe that just wins the game. We maybe could have kept a fetch handy. Like if he were to electrolyze the Heritage Druids in response to the Glimpse here. If we had a fetch in play, we could crack every Dryad Arbor and save one of the Heritage Druids with the Curio trigger. With the Curio ability on the stack. I'm actually going to pact for another Nettle Sentinel. Nettle Sentinel. Since we have Glimpse going, we don't need to get Visionary or anything weird. And I believe we're infinite at this point. We'll give Larry to realize it. Yep. All right. We talked about that earlier. Cards by name. So against Twin, I think Choke's a fine sideboard card. They can play around it, but they do have a lot of islands. I don't know. Our ability to combo might be more important than Choke, because I also want to bring in Thoughtseize and Abrupt Decay. As we saw that last game, if he hadn't been on a Moldavore, he might have just killed us on turn four. And so having a Thoughtseize or Abrupt Decay seems important. And I don't think like Choke or Thrunner are any good at all. Radiant Shaman might kill a might kill. What devil is that card? Oh, Spellskite. I don't think it's worth worrying about though. Got Scrib Ranger. Got Pact. Cut Dry Diver because we're cutting Scrib Ranger. And there we go. Well, I could bring in the second Essence Warden. It's mostly here as a Ranger of Yuss target against like burn decks and stuff. Or like Delver decks that are trying to apply a lot of pressure in race. But Essence Warden effects are pretty good against Twin. Like it means they need like a Pestermite or they need to kill the Essence Warden. So I'm gonna bring it in and I'm gonna cut like an Arbor Elf or something. I think that's fine. Just redundant combo killer.